Thursday, I was honored to receive the former Assistant Secretary of State of the United States, Roger Noriega, in my office. We sat there and talked for hours, and I took him to Parliament, had a special meeting with the Foreign Affairs Committee, came back to my office, and I said, you know, that flag on your wall, is that a Cuban flag? It looks like a Cuban flag. I said, you know, it's a flag of Papua, and that there is a resemblance there. It's here as well. That flag is on the wall of my office, and it's not there without a reason. It's there because I am on your side, and my party is on your side. This is an official statement, and you can check the history of the PVV statements in Parliament and outside Parliament, where I as a spokesman for Indonesia and surrounding areas, have consistently spoken on your behalf, support for your case. But I want to mention several things that worry me in that respect. Coming back to the flag first, and to the reason that I am also personally very occupied with your story and with your struggle. When I was young, I'm from 1955, I was born in a Dutch Reformed family. And every Sunday I went to church, of course, and we had children in church in a week. And there was very often a reference to Papua and to the people that came from the Netherlands and brought the gospel to Papua. And there were still people doing that in the days that I was young. People traveled there, Dutch people, and that was after 1961. And this has always occupied me. I was, when I became a politician, and I was touched by the Papua issue because it was on the agenda of my party, I made a reference very automatically to those memories of the past, where I was confronted with people very far away that needed our support, that was already in those days, but it was more emotional support, it was not out of guilt, it was out of compassion, more personal compassion with the people living very far away in a former colony of the Dutch. This is a memory, and I think that is the most important thing that you have accomplished in the past few years, is that you have retrieved the memory, not only for yourself, but for the political realm here. You were not on the political map for a very long time, but the past few years, thanks to your leadership, among others, it has been returned to our conscience. And I mentioned conscience with a very important purpose, because we have a debt of honor, and I've mentioned this before here in this house, a debt of honor to your people. I will not go back to all the reasons why we have that, because those have probably been mentioned already, but I want to emphasize that this debt, for me, is also a personal debt of honor. And I know that this is for my party chairman, Geert Wilders, who received the flag of Papua after the demonstration last year on the plain outside the House of Parliament. Debt of honor, what does that mean? You can sort of fill it in with artifacts, you can fill it in with symbols that might mean nothing. We want to do political work with that debt of honor. And I'm very honored that in our house, there is a very broad support for that. I mean, this is a representation of not every party in Parliament, unfortunately, but we, Parliament accepted a resolution for my party last year that deals with the Papua issue. And it is not the only resolution. There was a resolution of the case from the state, there was a resolution of the Vorderwind. And this is a building. This is a building that you should use. And you should keep us involved because of those resolutions. You can always rely on us because we were committed because of these resolutions. But you should always help us remind that this is an issue that we should work for. Because there is much on the agenda, as you know. There was reference by Harry van Bommel to the issue of the Moluccans, which is also on our hearts, in our hearts, also with me personally. And I find it very difficult to separate those, because they're both debts of honor. And now that brings me to the most important reason that I want to address you today. Much to my dismay, I have noticed the past year, since I've been working with the Papua community in the Netherlands, that there's not a unity. There's no unity. There are four or five organizations and they're not synchronizing their efforts. And I think that is to the detriment of your goal. So I hope that you will consider, after I've been I finish my speech that you will consider going for unity, because that is the only way to accomplish something. I really hope that you are willing to consider working together for the good cause that you represent. Final thing that I want to mention. When there's a darkness, like in Papua at the moment, darkness, there's nobody that reports from that area. We don't know what's happening. In the darkness, everything can happen. You need only one match in a very dark place to light it up. One match. Try it at home. You don't need a big lamp or a big bulb to do that. One match. One journalist inside could enlighten the situation. This is also what we are fighting for here, that the Dutch government will push the Indonesian government for transparency and for opening Papua territory for journalists and NGOs. There should be a lot of matches there to enlighten the situation. If we fail in that respect, we might discover after a while that atrocities have taken place. I was mentioning of atrocities last year in December. And we still don't know what really happened. And I questioned my Minister of Foreign Affairs on the issue. He said, you know, there was a lot of exaggeration there. I said, how do you know? Nobody was there, that was no match. I said, you know, we have reports from the Indonesian government, but also from local organizations, NGOs, that the situation is a bit more nuanced than was brought out by Papua organizations in the Netherlands. This is also an assignment to you, as far as I'm concerned, that you try to keep the information as concise as possible, also as credible as possible. Don't exaggerate, but inform us. Keep informing us all the time, and then you will have that match in your hand as well. I want to finish with the flag. You know, the Harry Van said, taking down a flag is not a crime. Having a flag, that is not a crime. It is a crime in Papua, it's a crime. But, you know, taking down a flag, like the Indonesian government is doing, is a sign of weakness as well. If that is the thing they do, they're afraid of the consequences of your national feelings. I'm not going to indulge here in political statements about what we expect you to do with your right to self-determination. It's a very tough thing, also in the Dutch parliament. There's no consensus on how you should fill that in. And I tell you, with peaceful means, you have us on your side. Struggle for it, but use non-violent means, use diplomacy, and use us. Thank you very much.
This is something, the symbol of the people of West Papua. It contains the bones, and you can see this, all the symbols that our father gave to the sons, and there's this flag, and all the symbols. And this is our national anthem that is recognized by our father. And this is our father draw the map of West Papua. This is our father draw the map. And you can see it, Middle and beginning. And this is the word of the Prime Minister. He said, look the future with the confidence in the justice of your case, and knowing that you will always be in our minds, and our best wishes will accompany you, and may God bless you and save you. This is the word we always hope that our justice will become, because you are give confidence, all of you are give confidence for us. And any longer, our tear will becoming shorter and will free. They are really confident. Thank you very much. And this is the bag that people of West Papua send. Thank you very much.